Hello everyone, good morning to all. In previous lecture, we have discussed Kumada, Hiyama coupling and Hegg coupling, Stille coupling. Like that, in today's lecture, we have to discuss next palladium catalyzed coupling. Name of that coupling reaction is Suzuki coupling reaction or Suzuki coupling. You all know that in 2010, Suzuki for this reaction are Suzuki plus Hegg and Nigishi, with all these three reaction getting Nobel Prize for such a innovative work. So that will be we have to discuss in today's lecture, what will be happens in that Suzuki coupling. In this Suzuki coupling, this one is reaction between same alkyl or aryl halide, and another coupling partner is here organoborane or boronic acids or organoborane compounds. In short, organoborane compound. Okay, organoborane means here in this coupling reaction there are two metals are involved. First one palladium and this second boron. Palladium and borons are involved, and some bases are also involved in this Suzuki coupling reaction. If we consider the definition of Suzuki coupling reaction, this Suzuki coupling reaction nothing but the palladium catalyzed coupling, palladium catalyzed coupling reaction between aryl or alkyl halide, aryl or alkyl halides and organoborans or organoborane compounds. This Suzuki coupling nothing but the reaction between aryl or alkyl halide and organoborans in presence of palladium catalyst. Okay. So here again we get form new bond, that is carbon-carbon bond. Here carbon-carbon new bond is formed. Then if we consider general reaction for this Suzuki coupling, like previous example or previous reaction, here first reactant or coupling partner is aryl or alkyl halide and second one is organoborane compound. Organoborane compound. In presence of palladium catalyst, palladium 0 as a catalyst, and second base are used and some solvent, ligand are also there. We get a coupled product here, R1 coupled with R2, where this R1 as well as R2 may be aryl or alkyl. Here this R group means this R which attach to boron, sometimes may be alkyl or OH or alkoxy. That part we will discuss in different example. If we see that example, at that time we consider that R group as a OH, alkoxy or alkyl group, and here our X is same as like previous examples, iodine, chlorine, bromine, triplet, such a type of X is there, means X is having iodine, chlorine, bromine or triplet, and some different base are used. Generally, NaOH, Na2CO3, cesium carbonate, potassium carbonate, CO3. Such a type of bases are involved in this Suzuki coupling reaction. Suzuki coupling reaction nothing but the palladium catalyzed coupling reaction between RI or alkyl halide and organoborane compound. Here this one is general reaction for that Suzuki coupling reaction. After this general reaction, we have to discuss a catalytic cycle for this Suzuki coupling reaction. So before that, we will again discuss general reaction. So this one is aryl or alkyl halide coupled with organoborane compound in presence of palladium catalyst. Some bases are used, solvent are used, and we get a coupled product. So this one is general reaction for Suzuki coupling reaction. Now next part of this reaction is catalytic cycle. Now we have to discuss catalytic cycle for Suzuki coupling reaction. Catalytic cycle. Here same like previous some reactions. First one is oxidative addition. Catalytic cycle goes through first oxidative addition, but second step are different. Here metathesis will be takes place. Okay, metathesis takes place is in between organoborane compound and base. Metathesis is takes place in between organoborane compound and bases. So that will be we will discuss in catalytic cycle. Next step in that catalytic cycle is same as like previous, that is transmetallation, and last step is obviously there is reductive elimination. So that catalytic cycle we will discuss. First palladium with some ligand shows oxidative addition on alkyl halide, we get connectivity like this. Then second step is metathesis. Second step is metathesis. Here before that we will discuss R2 okay plus this base like NaOH, Na2CO3, K2CO3, such a type of base are involved. OR means alkoxy group are there. After metathesis, this metathesis step is not involved here. After metathesis, this halogen from palladium, goes to this metal, and this OR group goes on palladium. Here we get MX, and here that OR group from metal comes to palladium. OR is there with some ligand is there. Means here halogens are directly eliminated in metathesis step. This one is our metathesis step. Okay, metathesis step. The next one is transmetallation. Next one is transmetallation. transmetallation with organoborane compound R2BOR, or here we taking R. Here that in some cases this R2 may be alkoxy is there, or when this organoborane compound reacts with some bases, here one group will be replaced with alkoxy group is there. Here transmetallation takes place, R1 and ligand as it is, but this OR group from this palladium goes to that boron, and here R2 group comes on palladium. Here OR and R2 is there. This one is new connectivity, and last step is our same, that is reductive elimination, and we get a coupled product. Last one is reductive elimination, and we get here a coupled product. This one is catalytic cycle for Suzuki coupling reaction. First one is oxidative addition takes place of palladium in alkyl halide. Then second one is metathesis, in that halogen will be replaced by alkoxy group. And second last transmetallation from one aryl or alkyl group from boron migrated on palladium, and this OR group migrated on that boron group. And last one is reductive elimination. We get a coupled product here, and palladium in zero oxidation state. This one is catalytic cycle for Suzuki coupling reaction. Then next part, you can take screenshot for this coupling instead of writing this all data. So next part is examples related to this Suzuki coupling reaction. Next one is examples. First example, R1 here, R2 okay, here we get a product A, and secondly first, and here product B is there. In first step, simply hydroboration reaction takes place. Product for that R2, R1, here boron, this one is catechol borane, which shows hydroboration reaction, and this one is nothing but the organoborane compound that will be react with this one is aromatic compound which contain bromine, and in presence of palladium means here actually our Suzuki coupling reaction will be takes place. And here product B is like this, R2, R1 as it is. Here AR group is the new bond form in between this carbon and this AR group, means aromatic group is there. So next example related to this Suzuki coupling reaction is, for that we rub this one, this is nothing but our organoborane compound and this one is our aryl halide, and here palladium in presence of DMA K2PO4 as a base metal base, and we get a couple product like this. New carbon-carbon bond is formed in between this carbon and this halogenated carbon, means boron attached with that carbon and halogen attached with that carbon. In that two carbon, there is a formation of new carbon-carbon bond. Okay, so this one is second example related to our Suzuki coupling reaction. Next example, this one is our organoborane compound and this one is our aryl halide. In presence of palladium catalyst, we get couple product in this reaction. Halogenated carbon is this one, and in organoborane, borane attached to this carbon, and new bond is formed in this two, in between that two carbon, and we get a product like this. Here two rings as it is with this methyl group, and new bond is formed in between these two carbon. Okay, means here halogenated carbon and boron attached carbon will be get new bond formation. Okay, this one is data related to our Suzuki coupling. First definition, in that we discuss aryl or alkyl halide in presence of palladium catalyst coupled with organoborane compounds. Okay, we get a couple product, then we discuss a general reaction for that Suzuki coupling reaction. After that we discuss catalytic cycle. In that catalytic cycle we discuss four different steps. First one is oxidative addition, second one is metathesis, then transmetallation, and last one reductive elimination, and after that we get couple product. Okay, then we discuss some examples related to this Suzuki coupling. Okay, then next reaction we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you.